Whoa, lordy, lordy. Look at that thing. Tell me that's not a fighter, hey? Look at that. Look at that. That is a slab, dude. Oh, yes. There's nothing wrong with that, boy. Nothing wrong with that. I don't care where you fish, man. You catching crappie like that. A little hair jig. Look where he's got the little Popeye jig. Look at that, man. The meat, the plastic, or the hair jig? Which is it? A lot of people have been asking me about different baits to use for crappie. They watch our series, they watch our YouTube channel, and see that we use quite a bit of variety of different things, from crank baits to twitch baits, even some topwater waking, blade baits, and a lot of plastics, because we all know plastics work. Now let's make sure we understand. We all know that live bait, any type of minnow will catch crappies. Whether you're fishing deep, shallow, under a float, single poling, dragging, I don't care how you're fishing them, they do catch crappie. But this is about the angler who wants to fish with artificials. He doesn't want to get his hands all scaly, doesn't want to get his rod, all kinds of minnow scales on it and stuff. He just wants to catch fish, and I can guarantee you there are scenarios where the hair jig and soft plastics will totally outproduce minnows. I'd say 100 to 1. Take that to the bank, because I've been fishing a long time and I know it does that. Cold water conditions, spider rigging and stuff, yes, absolutely. Live bait, meat does prevail. But when you're going one-on-one or under a float and you found those crappie either spooked in clear water, pre-spawn, or they just don't want to eat something big and flashy, plastic cranks or whatever, they will eat a hair jig. This is all about the hair jig, a couple options on how to fish it, so you can catch them too with something other than meat or the plastic. This week, I'm gonna show you, man, another little bait. And I always use plastic. You see the plastic all the time in single poling and using little bobbers and stuff too. But sometimes that little hair pulsating, marabou, bucktail, whatever it is, what you use too, is a different look for the crappie. And with that big white eye and the little jig head, small hook, that's 1/16th ounce. When they go, it's gone. They eat it. And your little bobber, little float, is gonna catch them. We're gonna do it right here on this segment of the Xtreme Crappie Angler on a low ceiling day before the rain. Yep. Oh, look at that, eh? Whoa. Little Popeye jig has found me crappie. I'd say that's a pretty good crappie to start, huh? Look how he ate that jig up. Look at that. What do you think, eh? You all know who Popeye is, and you know that he loves spinach, right? Well, I got a feeling that these crappie are gonna like that little jig right there. You see that little hair jig with the big eye? Pop. That's what a hair jig looks like. There's so many different models on the internet, independent tires, companies, you name it. These guys who tie these up all over Facebook and Instagram, Twitter, you can't go a day without seeing some fantastic different examples of different hair jigs. We like the little ones with the big eye, the big jig, small little hook, super, super sharp. Sharpness is number one, because whether you're fishing under a float or fishing single pole, sometimes it can be some of the biggest crappie of the year. So you got to make sure that the hook is solid. Okay. I'm not talking about a real thick gauge. I'm just talking about very ultra sharp where it just sticks. I call it like sticking into concrete or sticking into granite. When you drop it, it'll stick. There are hooks like that. Buyer beware. There are ones that are very cheap on the internet. Don't break your heart, because sometimes they actually crack at the shaft as well. So it's up to you what you want to buy. We like the ones that actually catch crappie and not just have them inhale it and then the hook breaks and you're heartbroken as well. So think about what you buy. about the different hair jigs on the market. There's all types and all colors, but just pick the different ones that give you confidence, because at the end of the day, this is what it's all about. You having confidence in catching crappie with baits like the hair jig.
Whoa, lordy, lordy. Look at that thing. I mean, that's kind of fighter, hey? Look at that. Look at that. That is a slab, dude. Oh, yes. There's nothing wrong with that, boy. Nothing wrong with that. I don't care where you fish, man. You're catching crappie like that. A little hair jig. Look where he's got the little Popeye jig.
Look now, when you're throwing a hair jig, think about the soft, slender bite floats, okay? I like the ones that are more streamlined, okay? You see me use the bubble ones as well. But the streamlined ones, great option. The ones guys use a lot for steelhead, another fantastic option, okay? I rig it so it's just below the water line, okay? So maybe half inches above the water. Really easy to detect soft bites, pulls, and the crappie don't even feel the hair. And last but not least, you know it, man. It's that little cheap one that you can pick up at all the big box stores on the internet. You know, little styrofoam little thing, but they work. They're excellent when using hair jigs. Think about the bobbers that are out there. Use the ones that you want to use to give you confidence, like I said. But just think, have some variety in your boat, depending on the conditions, wave conditions, current, the depth you're fishing. The floats can be your best friend or worst enemy.
Beautiful, beautiful. Awesomely designed little bait. Little hair jig. Wow, I'm using pliers, man. You know that you got it good when you got to use the pliers. Just bend it and turn it. But that's the kind of fish I came for right here, right there. And this little bait, I mean, dudes, set up on a light bite right there. That with that is sore lipping them all.
I'm single pulling these little babies. Whatever color suits you, depending on the water clarity, where you're fishing, you know, it's all angler preference, really. But I like the light tones, something natural, white, grays, a little bit of blue. If the water.
Oh, that's another good one, Josh.
Yep, I'm right here this time.
Oh, wow. Thanks, man.
No problem.
That was ghost fishing again, dude, just in front of the boat.
That's the way to do it, eh?
Ghost fishing. But you know what I do? I pitch it out and I hold it with my other hand, Josh, so the jig is going really slow. Because I've watched these fish, they don't really want to chase, but if you go slow and stop it,
they bang. Want it.
I did it exactly there, and it's as soon as I stopped the jig, tick. So I know you followed it out decent, but we got a few more like that for pictures, don't we, Josh, eh?
Oh, yes, we do.
All right.
A few more to come.
Well, for fun. Go on, boy. Wow. I tell you, man, this is just incredible. Catch them this way. One-on-one.
This is too much fun.
Crappie. Whew.
If the water's off color, I'll go to the bright chartreuses, something with brown, greens, you know, black with different contrasting colors like pink or white. Totally up to you. But think about the little hair jig when you pick up that jig pole, because when they see this, man, oh man, they eat this.
I just, there we go. Netter?
Yeah, maybe.
Okay. Bring him around, Josh. Bring him around. Let's bring him this way. Hey.
Oh,
there
geez.
You go.
There you go.
That's a plate, man. Are you kidding? Definitely netter.
Oh.
Wow.
Nice one, huh?
Now you tell me if that is fun.
That's beyond fun.
Now, are hair jigs the only answer? Absolutely not. Being a versatile crappie fisherman is key to catching them on different bodies of water, different conditions, different times of the year, water temperature. There's a lot of factors involved, but having hair jigs in your boat, again, just go on social media and watch how many guys tie up little hair jigs. Deadly color combinations, anything you want they can tie up, because they know these little hair jigs have caught crappie way before you and I ever picked up a jig pole or a float. Think about the hair jig next time you're fishing. They do catch crappie. Thanks for watching our video. Hope you put your comments below. Hope you subscribe, and we'll see you somewhere, anywhere, as long as you're fishing for crappie. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and like us on all our pages dedicated to crappie in the links below in the description section of this video.